Could I please ask Esther Gicheru to talk about the Kenyan experience? And whilst she prepares, I will also prepare by putting up the slide.
Okay. Yeah, thank you very much. And as you prepare the slides, I want to say I'm very pleased to be in this forum today where we are sharing about our cooperative experience. Yeah, because for me, I'm one of the believers in cooperatives. And even the fact that Kenya as a country has embraced cooperatives for a long time. Without cooperatives, I don't think our economy would be where it is today. Yeah, so I'm happy today to be talking about the Kenyan experience. And I'll be, first of all, talking about just a small definition of a cooperative, and then make reference to the cooperative principles. And I'll also give the history of the Kenyan cooperative movement very briefly. Then I look at the working environment of Kenya's cooperative sector. I mention about the successful cooperative ventures in Kenya, and then the challenges that we go through and the critical success factors that we need to address. Yeah, so in terms of definition, I want to talk about the definition that is given by the ICA. And cooperatives are defined as an autonomous association of persons united voluntarily to meet their common economic, social, and cultural needs and aspirations through a jointly owned and democratically controlled enterprise. And we know about the cooperative identity, the statement, which includes the cooperative principles and values, and that definition I have just gone through. And in most countries, including Kenya, when we develop our national policies and legal frameworks, we are guided by these principles and the values, and which including most significantly protecting and fostering the autonomy of cooperatives. And as part of the international cooperative movement, all cooperatives in Kenya conduct their business in accordance with the internationally shared cooperative principles and values. And that's why I said they are enshrined in our policy document and also in the legal framework so that it serves as a reminder all the times. Now, the purpose of cooperatives, the cooperatives are established by its members, driven by the need to do business together and benefit from economies of scale. The members, they strive to optimize their economic, social, and cultural needs. And in so doing, cooperatives strengthen the communities in which they operate. We know about cooperatives, they promote participative economies because the democratic decision-making in cooperatives allows everybody to have a voice in the business of the cooperative. Now, looking at Kenya's background, I would like to say that our first cooperative society in Kenya was registered in 1908, and this was the preserve of the white settlers to develop and market their agricultural crops. So this time, the cooperatives were not really from bottom up. I have said there, they were started by the white settlers to meet their own needs. But the local people were being used as to provide labor in these cooperatives. And it was not until the 1950s that the Lok people, the Kenyan people, the Africans, were allowed to form cooperatives. So by the time we were receiving independence in 1963, we had about 1,000 registered cooperatives. And by the 1960s and 70s, there was a rapid growth of the cooperatives. And we also formed important national organizations at the national level, whereby every sector would bring together all the cooperatives that are that sector. Say, for example, is the dairy sector, the coffee sector, the savings and credit sector. So they formed these cooperatives. We called them NACOs in short, the National Cooperative Organizations. And this included, today we have the CAK, the Cooperative Alliance of Kenya, normally, formerly was known as the Kenya Federation of National Federation of Cooperatives, and that is the apex organization that was formed in 1964. And then the Cooperative Bank of Kenya in 1968, then the Kenya Union of Savings and Credit Cooperatives in 1971, and the Cooperative Insurance Company of Kenya and National Cooperative Housing Union in 1978. So all these were serving the various sectors of the economy, because all sectors in Kenya of the economy, their cooperatives cut across. Although some of the NACOs died, like the one dealing with the milk and also coffee, but they have been restructured, and we now have new formation of those cooperatives. And currently, the types of cooperatives that are active in Kenya include marketing cooperatives, banking, insurance, the SACOs, and the housing and transport. We also now have our youth also coming up with workers' cooperatives in various sectors. Today we have about 22,883 registered cooperatives, cooperative societies in Kenya, according to the statistics at the State Department of Cooperatives. And we have a membership of about 14 million Kenyans who are members of these cooperatives. Cooperatives have mobilized over $6 billion, which is about half of the country's GDP as deposits and asset base, worth over $5 billion. And cooperatives in Kenya have been forefront in mobilizing savings and investments through provision of affordable loans. And it has resulted to huge impact in financial deepening among Kenyans. And like I mentioned, the cooperative principles are embraced in all our documents. I don't have to go through them. I'm sure we are all familiar with the 7 principles. And these are the ones that we have been using to use the cooperative values of equity, equality, solidarity, democracy, caring for others into action. So we have been using the number 1 to 7 principles. I don't have to say so much about them. I'm sure being a cooperative forum, I know we are familiar with them. Now, the significance of cooperatives in Kenya. We have Kenya Cooperative Movement. Currently, it is ranked as number 1 in Africa and number 7 internationally. We have, as a result of this, been receiving many delegations in Kenya from especially our African countries, so that they can learn from our experience. Yeah, learn from our experience. We also note that in July 2013, the World Council of Credit Unions also recognized Kenya as the fastest growing subsector in the world. That is the SACCOS, which are the savings and credit cooperatives. The cooperative enterprises have also generated employment opportunities for over 1 million people and indirectly for 2.5 million people. 63% of Kenya's population participate directly or indirectly in cooperative-based enterprises. And 80% of Kenya's population derives their income either directly or indirectly from the cooperative activities. Looking at the way the cooperative movement is structured, we can see we have a four-tier system where we have the primary cooperative, where individuals are the members of the cooperative. And then we have the secondary cooperatives. These are at the districts or county levels where two or more primary cooperatives join together to form a cooperative. Then we have the tertiary cooperatives, which I called the NACOS, where more than two secondary cooperatives join together to form a NACO. And then the apex organization, where the tertiaries and even the secondaries and primary are free to join as the apex organization, which is our spokesperson, both at national and international levels. Now, for the working environment of Kenya's cooperative sector, we have an environment where we have the government working together with other sectors. Now, for the government, it is the official agency for coordinating cooperative development in Kenya. And the roles played by the government include formulation of policy, legislation, audit of cooperatives. And because the government cannot audit all the cooperatives, they audit only the weak ones, but they register cooperative auditors to which other bigger cooperatives apply to get their auditors. Then we also have arbitration, which is also enshrined in the government. And we have an established cooperative tribunal so that if we have disputes in cooperatives, instead of taking them to the normal court, which may not understand how cooperatives run, they are arbitrated through the cooperative tribunal. Then we also have marketing and development activities under the ministry in charge of cooperatives. Then there is the legislative work through various sessional papers. That's what I talked about, the formulation of policies and the implementation of cooperative purpose. At our blueprint, the Kenya Vision 2030, and our Vision 2030, which steers our economic development, we have recently devoted it to what we call the Big Four agenda. So we are concentrating mainly on providing affordable housing to our citizens, food security, ensuring self-sufficiency, and good nutrition. And then health, that is providing universal health care. And then finally, enhancing manufacturing to ensure value addition. So cooperatives are ensuring that they participate in this Big Four agenda for the development of our country through cooperatives. Now, we also have what we call the SACCO Society's Regulatory Authority. This is a statutory state corporation, and this was established in the year 2008 through an act of parliament. And the purpose of this is to license and regulate all deposit-taking cooperative societies, because under the savings and credit cooperatives category, we have those which act like banks. And so they receive deposits from the members, apart from what they have saved in cooperatives. Even if they are those who are salaried, their salaries go through those circles. Therefore, there was a need for their regulation because cooperatives are not regulated by the Central Bank of Kenya. So that's why the SACCO Society Regulatory Authority was created. So it effectively regulates and supervises in order to develop the SACCO industry. Then under that area of regulation, we also have the Kenya Union of Savings and Credit Cooperatives. And this is the voice of savings and credit cooperatives in Kenya. And the main law is in the area of advocacy. In case there are issues that are affecting cooperatives in the country and they need to be lobbied to the government, then the Kenya Union of Savings and Credit Cooperatives plays that law. And then also representation as the umbrella body of all the savings and credit cooperatives. They also provide financial and technical assistance for some of the SACCOs are not able to do their own bookkeeping or even maybe do recruitment for qualified and professional staff. So the CUSCO, in short we call it CUSCO, comes in to assist those cooperatives. They also undertake research in the sector to ensure that any issues affecting the sector come up and solutions are provided. Then I want to talk about the successful cooperative ventures in Kenya because we have institutions, like I said, covering various sectors. And in the education sector, we have the Cooperative University of Kenya, that is where I work, and which started long ago in 1952 as a college. That time we were working together with the other East African countries, Kenya, Uganda, and Tanzania, and we had established a school in Kenya, School of Cooperation. But around 1969, we then separated, and Kenya formed its own cooperative college in Kenya. And for a long time, it worked to provide certificate and diploma level programs. And we also, that is for the cooperative movement and also for the government in order to train those people who are supervising cooperatives in Kenya. But as we continued, we found that the cooperative movement was growing and diversifying, and we needed to introduce higher level training programs. And in the year 2005, we introduced the first degree in cooperative business, which we offered that time in collaboration with one of our local universities. But as we started that journey, we then became upgraded as the Cooperative University of Kenya and awarded a charter in the year 2016. So the university caters and provides the cooperative education and training to our cooperatives and even outside the borders. Then we have the Cooperative Bank of Kenya. Like I mentioned, there are many institutions where we work together as the pillars of the cooperative movement, which was founded in 1965. Today it has grown to be the third largest bank in the country, and it is owned by the cooperative societies. It manages also an insurance agency and stock brokerage company. It has branches not just in Kenya, it has also in South Sudan, and I think lately it was also moving to work in Ethiopia. It is also listed on Nairobi Securities Exchange. There is a window that was opened for cooperative members to trade through the national securities. In their CSR policy, the bank has sponsored about 4,000 students every year in secondary and university education. And these are children of cooperators. One of the criteria for the sponsorship is that they have to be children of cooperators and who cannot afford fees. So there is a criteria that we use to ensure we get the right students. Then we have the Cooperative Insurance Company of Kenya. And this one again started in 1968 and it is licensed as a composite insurance company to light all classes of business trading in the name of Cooperative Insurance Services in 1978. And this one is also listed on Nairobi Security Exchange. And again, it is the third largest insurance company in Kenya. It has branches in Kenya, Uganda, South Sudan, and Malawi. Now, the other organization that we have is the National Housing Cooperative Union, and this is for housing. So it has been involved in providing technical support and capacity building at the community level and offering financial support to housing cooperatives, also playing the role of advocacy, networking, and lobbying for housing cooperatives. It supports the growth of housing cooperatives in Kenya, and the recent World Bank report indicated that 9 out of 10 housing units in Kenya are constructed through cooperatives. So this is also a very successful area. We have also what we call the diaspora cooperatives, because Kenyan people have moved all over the world, and as they work outside there, they were looking back home to see how they can invest. And the Kenyan government again came at heart and supported the development of diaspora cooperatives. This was launched in the year 2014. And that was after the first diaspora-based SACCO, Saves and Credit Cooperatives, was registered in 2012 for Kenyans based in the USA. But immediately after that, it spread to other countries. We have diaspora cooperatives in 14 countries, about 20 of them registered in different countries. And in support of the policy, the State Department for Cooperatives, in collaboration and support of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, promoted and registered 16 SACCOs as at the end of 2016, but now I'm saying there are 20. And although before the idea was only to promote the savings and credit cooperatives, now it has become obvious that there is need for other types of cooperatives by the diaspora, and therefore we are looking into ways how we can support and help the promotion of other different investment cooperatives. So that has already been captured in our current draft cooperative development policy, which is underway, and we'll see how they can participate in other types of cooperatives. Like I mentioned, we have the challenges that face the cooperatives in Kenya, and we have challenges which include mismanagement, weak producer prices, and also like when we have global crises that are experienced, we see that they also affect the cooperative sector. Issues of low interest margins have also been affecting our banking industry and the cooperatives. The other area now currently that is also an issue is the COVID-19 pandemic, and cooperatives are monitoring the impact this is going to have on the cooperatives. Some of the issues that we have seen, especially in the savings and credit cooperatives, is the low uptake of loans, and also the slowing down of loan repayment, restricted movement. So we are monitoring this, and also the cooperatives are coming up with the response mechanisms to see how we can support our members during this very critical period. So on the critical success factors, some of the things that cooperatives in Kenya have embraced and continue to embrace is the use of ICT, because technology is very important for the growth of cooperatives, And this has been in place. Most of our cooperatives are computerized. Customer service, we do a lot of customer survey to understand our members and any of our customers. And member education, not just through the cooperative university, but also each and every cooperative, they have their own education units and education committees where they carry out education to their members. Because without education and training, cooperatives will not succeed. And that is even the reason why the Cooperative Training Institution was started during those very, very early years in 1969. Then the compliance with the government regulations has also been very important. That has also helped the cooperatives to grow. The engagement of qualified board members and also professional management within the cooperatives. Then the other advantage and critical factor has been the affiliation to a robust international network, because like we know, cooperatives are practiced at local level and also at international level, and that affiliation to the international networks have helped the cooperatives to grow locally, because we are able to tap the ideas that are shared at those international levels. Then we have also been employing best corporate governance and management practices. We have training programs at the university that promote good cooperative governance, and we make sure that our directors and members of boards of our cooperatives go through these programs before they are elected or immediately they are elected to the board. So we have worked together as the pillars I have mentioned, the university, the ministry in charge of cooperatives, the National Housing Cooperative Union, the Cooperative Bank, and the Cooperative Insurance Company, and also the CUSCO, Kenya Union of Savings and Credit Cooperatives. That working together is what has made us form what we call the cooperative movement. And then within that, we now work towards the achievement of the contents of the Vision 2030 of Kenya, which I said has now been reduced to the big four agenda that now our cooperatives are participating in. So I want to stop there because of time. I think I have covered the essential areas just to show how our cooperative movement in Kenya looks like. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed, Esther Gicheru.